We are back in the Reese's Kitchen for yet another Fun Food Friday. And with us this week is Chef Shelley Brown from the Boston Avenue Grill. Good morning.
Good morning.
Well, you have the perfect recipe for a day like today. We're making some sweet and spicy chili, right?
That's correct, yes.
So is this a popular dish for you guys down there?
It's very popular, especially when it gets really cold. This is what everyone wants is our sweet and spicy chili.
So this has been a top seller for the past week, probably.
Absolutely.
So what's the first step here?
First step is I have some lean ground beef here, and I've been browning it for about 5 to 7 minutes, and then I threw in one medium diced yellow onion and got that working. So this is about 5 to 7 minutes, and after we do that, I throw in 2 tablespoons of fresh minced garlic.
Okay.
And I would normally let this go for another minute or two. After that, I throw in 1 can of diced tomatoes, about a 15-ounce can.
Okay.
And then I would throw in my 1 can of my favorite baked beans.
And what are your favorite baked beans?
These are Vandekamp's baked beans.
Okay.
Good old-fashioned baked beans. So I would let this marry together for a few minutes, and then it's time for my seasonings. I have about 1/2 cup of light brown sugar.
Okay. And just watching you make this, a lot of people are stranded at home right now.
It seems
like a lot of these ingredients are probably something people have maybe already in their house.
Exactly. Just hanging out. 1/4 cup of dark chili powder.
Okay.
And then I have my ground red pepper. This is about 2 tablespoons. If you don't like it so spicy, then you can cut that about half.
So it's going to be pretty spicy.
Yes. So then I would salt and pepper this just to taste. We can always add some more at the end. And I would let this go for about 30 minutes. And
30 minutes, that's
30
all.
30 minutes or so, yep. The longer you let it sit, the spicier it gets. So.
Okay. And through the magic of television, we already have a finished product
here.
It looks fantastic. Can't wait to try it in just a few minutes. Before we do that, though, we do want to thank our friends here next door, the Old School Bagel Cafe. You know a thing or two about that place, right? Many of us, of course, have been stuck here at the station all week, basically with nothing to eat. So our friends next door here at the Old School Bagel Cafe, which has stayed open through all of this, amazingly enough, have provided us with a bunch of food. Of course, they make bagels, and they made us spaghetti one day this week. So who would have known the bagel shop can make spaghetti, but they can do it, and it was tasty, tasty stuff. So we want to say thank you to them, and we will be back to try this with Shelley in just a minute.